Hi everyone, in this video, we're gonna look at how we can understand our results from running MaxQuant last week. So each of you was able to get an individual data set from the PRIDE database. You should have downloaded the raw file and then made your own customized FASTA database full of human proteins from the human proteome and common laboratory contaminants. Now that you have this data set, we wanna understand the results that we got. So every single spectra in the mass spec raw file the software tried to match that to a peptide. Every peptide and then tries to be matched to a protein. And our goal at the end of a proteomics experiment is to end up with a list of unique proteins. So in this experiment, we're going to use BLAST to explore how the peptides relate to the proteins. How much of the sequence is in each individual peptide, you'll be able to see by looking at the alignment, and you'll also just get an idea of how this assigning of spectra to peptides to proteins works, that hierarchy. So the first thing we're gonna do is go to our MaxQuant results. So we can look at MaxQuant peptides for data 1 and 2. Data 1 was the raw file from PRIDE. Data 2 is that custom FASTA database that we made. And we can open it up in Galaxy, or we can look at it on our computer. So I'm going to just click the eyeball to look at it here, because that's a little bit faster. And we can see each sequence, the N-terminal cleavage window, the C-terminal cleavage window, each of the amino acids, and we can see what protein it's assigned to. So this first protein, I can copy this ID. And I can look it up on UniProt. And get the FASTA sequence. So you can see that this is an amino acid. It's specifically part of the ribosome. It's a 60S ribosomal protein, L4. And this is the sequence that we wanna be able to compare our short peptide sequence to. We go back to the first line on Galaxy, we're gonna be able to copy the amino acid sequence from column 1. And then we can go to BLAST and specifically protein BLAST to compare our long protein sequence to this short peptide. So I wanna align two or more sequences. I'm gonna have the query be the short peptide. I'm going to copy the sequence from UniProt, so the FASTA sequence, to be the subject. Some, you know, you could use a database, but since I checked this box, I'm only going to compare it to this one sequence. And then BLAST. It comes up pretty fast because we're not searching a whole database, we're just searching that one protein. And we can look at the alignment, we can see where they lined up. So we see that it's a short sequence, it's only 11 amino acids, but it's a perfect match. And where is it happening in the protein? It's happening at the end of the protein, amino acids 354 to 364. So if we go back to the sequence, we can probably find where that is located. Each of these is 70. We could even do, you know, control F and look for all of those alanines in a row. And you can see that it crosses these two lines. So the AAA, LQAQ, LQAK, that's the sequence that we're looking for, and it's there. So that's the general hierarchy of MaxQuant results: spectra, aligned peptides, peptides, and then are assigned to proteins. But the peptide will only be a small portion of the protein. So part of protein identification is finding out how many peptides map to the protein. The protein's there, we expect to see more than just one. And then you'll also look at the proteins, which ones are unique. So could this amino acid sequence have shown up anywhere else in the proteome? That's the question, the research question that we're trying to ask in the next couple of assignments. Good luck using Galaxy, and let me know if you have any questions.